Well, good morning, everyone. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with a look at the U.S. stock market for Tuesday morning. Things are fairly quiet out there this morning. Stock index futures trading right around fair value, while commodities are slightly higher on Tuesday morning. Monday was a sleepy summer day. We had the VIX had an inside day and trading in the channel for the second day in a row. And so certainly the VIX is fairly calm at the moment. We are still on a daily sell signal, and that, of course, is supportive for higher stock prices. The market moved higher yesterday with the Dow Diamonds making a new high. We saw the Spider ETF trade higher and the Qs trade higher. The Qs closed above the upper channel line for the first time in a couple of weeks, and that, of course, is bullish for the market. We did not generate a sell signal, so we saw a pullback, I saw consolidation, and now it looks like the market wants to move higher. Size does matter, and if we use the Wilshire 5000 as our baseline, we saw the large caps, mid cap, and small cap stocks all move higher on Monday. Of course, the mid cap and the small cap stocks still on a daily sell signal, so no change in trend there. No new buy signals for mid cap or small cap stocks, and micro cap stocks closed lower on Monday, so no joy there. Splitting up the market by sectors, consumer discretionary, consumer staples, still on buy signals, no change there. Energy stocks unfortunately generated a sell signal on Thursday. We saw a fall through to the downside on Monday. There's bank stocks having a little pullback on Monday. We need to close way down there at 25.05 on Tuesday, not expecting that to happen. Healthcare stocks still on a sell signal, no change there. Second day of a buy signal for industrials. No change in trend for material, still on a sell signal. We've had real estate stocks trading in the channel for the last couple of days, so just treading water, but still on a buy signal. There's the technology Spider ETF back trading above the upper channel line, just like the Qs. And there's the transports. The transports, of course, we were talking about how they were sliding and coming down towards the 200-day moving average last week. And, of course, as soon as we talked about that, the market started to reverse, and it looks like holding 164 is support. We traded up to the upper channel line yesterday. We need to close on Tuesday above 168.07, and I would certainly be looking to purchase my favorite transport stock if a new buy signal showed up. Looking at utilities, still on a buy signal, no change there. Looking at some of the commodity ETFs, we've got the gold miners on its second day of a sell signal there. Silver miners on the second day of a sell signal. Looking at the commodities themselves, there's the commodity tracking ETF. Has been trading in the channel for the last couple of days. A close below 14.73 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Not expecting that to happen with the commodities up in the pre-market this morning. There's the USO closing above the upper channel line on Monday. We need to close below 9.87 on Tuesday. Not expecting that to happen. No change in trend for natural gas on Monday. Now there's the GLD closing up below the lower channel line yesterday. So the GLD is back on a sell signal, joining the SLV, which generated a sell signal on Friday. Looking at the bond market, the futures contract inside day yesterday, no change there. No change for the TLT inside day. No change for junk bonds, but a close below 37.18 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Saw money go back into the emerging markets yesterday, so no change in trend there up at the recent high. Looking at currencies, inside day for the US dollar index, inside day for the euro, and there's the Canadian dollar on its second day of a sell signal. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Not expecting a lot of volatility on Tuesday, but this is earnings season, of course, and we could see some individual stock volatility on Tuesday. Have a great day, and the next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning, and at that time we'll take a look at the Canadian stock market.